Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. How y'all doing? Well, I'm in the kitchen and today I'm about to make me a good, hearty, healthy meal. And I'm starting out with fresh sweet potatoes. I just washed these sweet potatoes, so I'm gonna put some oil on them and I'm gonna put them in the oven and let them bake while I'm preparing the rest of my meal. I'm gonna do something a little different today. You know, I like to come up with my own recipes. But starting out, I'm gonna put these potatoes in the oven. So you know it takes potatoes about 45 minutes to an hour or more, because these are kind of big. And then when they get done, I can cut them in half. And I have some for my dinner today. This is Sunday, the last Sunday of the month of January. So I usually keep potatoes in my freezer, but I'm out. So it's time to cook more. Got them all oiled down, and I got little slits in the top. It's always good to put those slits in those potatoes. I've never had one to explode, but from my understanding, they can. And baby, you know I don't want to have to clean that up. That seemed like that'll be a real mess to clean. Okay, we're going to sit that up here. Okay, so this is a Cornish hen. So I'm gonna be putting this Cornish hen on. I'm gonna cook this hen on top of the stove. The last time I cooked Cornish hen, and I cooked my cauliflower stuffing with it. That stuffing was so good. But today I'm gonna do something a little bit different. You know I'm on my weight loss journey, so I'm learning to cook things a little different, but you know I want that taste, because if it don't taste good, what? You're right, Miss B not gonna eat it. Let me get this water off this hen. I'm gonna cut this hen and then I'm gonna wash it good and dry it off before I proceed on. All right, so I'm putting these potatoes in the oven. Okay, so what I'm gonna do with this hen, I'm gonna cut it in half. Got my two-handle skillet that I'm gonna be using today. It's nothing like a good cast iron skillet. This is a newer one my sister-in-law bought for me, but I have an old cast iron skillet to use. Put a little bit of olive oil in the pan. Let it start warming up a little bit. Now this Cornish hen, I'm gonna cut it in half. Gonna wash that and I'll be back. Okay, I got this hen all washed up. Gonna clean. Okay, so I'm going to use some Szechuan, ginger, little sage, kicking chicken, a little curry. Okay, I got my ginger, some garlic powder, onion powder, and black pepper. And just a little seasoned salt, and just a little bit of complete, not too much of complete. This is cauliflower. I don't want any big chunks in here. Remember before I made my veggie-based stuffing with cauliflower? So now I'm gonna try to make cauliflower mac and cheese. Not try, I'm gonna do it. I know it's gonna taste good. Okay, I'm put everything that I normally put in my mac and cheese, which is sour cream. Black pepper in my mac and cheese. A little seasoned salt. Usually put cheddar cheese, the Campbell's cheddar cheese. Normally I have more mac and cheese, so I'm not going to put all of this in there, I don't think. Maybe about a half of a can. Put a little bit of minced garlic in my hand. That was about a tablespoon before. Usually put buttermilk in my mac and cheese, and usually a little regular whole milk also. Usually put eggs in there. cut it up a little because I want it about the same size as the penne pasta that I probably would use. Sometimes I use the elbow, but usually with my mac and cheese, I use the penne pasta. Whole milk. Using Kobe Jack cheese. I think I'm going to use the rest of this Campbell's. A little Sazon. I also use a little mustard normally in my mac and cheese. One thing I am gonna do, I'm gonna put it in a dish that's a little more shallow. I don't usually like for my macaroni and cheese to be really thick. I think that would cook better. Okay, well, we're gonna put it in the oven and let it do what it do. Always add pure butter to my mac and cheese. Okay, and I'm gonna add some pure butter. I melted that in the microwave. I usually add a pinch of sugar, not all the time, but sometimes I add a pinch of sugar to my mac and cheese. I'm not using sugar, but I'm going to add just a little bit of equal. I know some people don't like to use artificial sweeteners, and that's fine. Use it all because I don't want it sweet. I just want it enough to bring out the flavor. Okay, so I'm also gonna fix some asparagus. Gonna season my pan. I already have olive oil in it. A little sazon, the black pepper. A little seasoned salt. Onion powder. And I'm gonna put these asparagus and roast them in the oven. Everything is in the oven. The hen's on top of the stove. So I'll be back to check on everything. Just about done. I add a little bit of Better Than Bouillon. just so good, the taste. So don't let the smell fool you. The taste is amazing. Barbecue pig feet that I cooked the other day. So I'm going to separate them and put them in the freezer. Then when you have a taste for something, you don't always have to go through the trouble of cooking everything from scratch. I'm a firm believer, as I get older, to store cooked food in the freezer. Some of my family might have a taste for barbecue pig feet. You can take it out and pop it in the microwave, or you can put it in the oven and add a little more barbecue sauce on it. And see, I got the name on there and the date. That's the one I'm putting it in the freezer. I think the date is 29th or the 30th, but nonetheless, it's close enough. I know when it's too old. The asparagus, they're all ready. I knew they would be the first to be ready. Oh yeah, they should. It's gonna be delicious. Okay, I'm gonna wrap them in a little foil and wait for my cauliflower macaroni and cheese and my sweet potato. Just gonna put them in a container instead. Then they'll be all ready for the fridge. Okay, that's asparagus. So the cauliflower mac and cheese is ready. It smells delicious. So the sweet potatoes are all ready. So that's everything. We have the Cornish hen over here. We have the cauliflower mac and cheese. We have asparagus here. And get a pot holder. And the sweet potatoes. So out of each of those sweet potatoes, I'll probably get about 4 pieces. Be able to put it in the freezer and have it for more than just one meal. So that's it. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with me as I prepared this meal. I really appreciate it. And if you would, please hit that subscribe button right there in the right-hand corner of your screen and turn on your post notification button. And give your girl a thumbs up if you like this video, okay? Well, all right, and I'll see you guys in my next video, okay? Bye-bye. So this is the end result. This is the sweet potato, the Cornish hen with carrots and onions stewed on top of the stove, asparagus, and my macaroni and cheese made with cauliflower. It is really delicious. Okay, I hope you guys will try this out. It really tastes good. Look at that. Doesn't it look good? Look at there. Mac and cheese made with cauliflower.